Hey, welcome back to the channel. This video, we're going to be covering a particular feature of Highlevel, creating domains for your websites and funnels. Although this isn't a major feature, it is something that everybody needs to do if you wish to host a website or a funnel inside of Highlevel. I'm going to show you how to configure domains and subdomains in this particular video. Before we continue, please click the subscribe on this button, click the video, the like and subscribe on this video if you think it's helpful. Let's get into it. Okay, so here we are in a sub account, and right now we're just at the dashboard. So I just want to go down here to the sites area. So right now, I'm just going to be dealing with websites for this particular presentation. Websites and funnels can be used interchangeably. They're the same settings. If you'd like to know the differences between both of them, check out my other video on the channel for websites and funnels. I go over all the differences, settings, and so forth for it. But today what we're going to be doing is we're just going to be covering websites and how to connect the domains to the websites. So here we see we've got three websites already created and designed here in this particular sub account, but what we're going to do is we're going to open up one of them. We go to the settings here, and we would typically just select the domain here that we want to assign to this particular website. Now, we don't have any domains here, so that's the whole point of this video, is to get some domains created here. So right now, in order to configure the domains, you're going to have to go into the settings of your sub account and then go into the domains area. Now, this does get a little bit complicated, not completely. Right now, the domain for this particular site that we're testing today is actually hosted through GoDaddy. I'm already logged into my GoDaddy account. I'm already inside of the domain settings for that particular domain, and I'm actually at the DNS record setting for that particular domain. So if you don't know how to do that, you might want to get technical support from your provider to help you out or have your tech person do this. But if you know how to do it, it's really much easier. It's a pretty simple process. You might have to wait a few minutes, but let's hop into it here. So creating a domain, we're just simply going to come up here and click Add Domain. It's going to pop up a box saying, what domain do you want to add? And gives us some instructions on how we need to proceed. So I'm going to type the domain in here. Okay, so I've got the domain. Notice that it says that we need to create an A record for this IP address. Please make sure you have an A record pointing to this IP. So what we're going to do is go into GoDaddy one at a time here. So here we are inside of GoDaddy. We're going to go ahead and click on Add New Record. We're going to select the A record like it was specified. Now here we're going to be putting the at symbol. Notice that they say at or www. This is basically just meaning, is this a root domain or is this a subdomain? So we're just going to use the at symbol. I'm going to come over here and paste the IP address. Now notice when I pasted this, you have to be careful, because if I try to save this right now, I'm going to get an error in the record is invalid. That's just because whenever I copied and pasted this, I copied and pasted there was a space at the end of that. So just be careful when you copy and paste. You should be able to click save. It'll update the DNS record. It says the record was created successfully. Perfect. Now we need to come over here, and it says we need to create a CNAME record for pointing to this address here. So we're going to go ahead and copy this, and we're going to come over here and create another record. And here from the option, we're just going to choose CNAME. Now, for the name of this, it does give you the information here. So we're pointing to this for complete massage and spa and domain. So that's what we're dealing with. And for the value here, we're just going to paste in the domain here. We're going to click save. Notice that this is just going to update. It should be pretty quick. Now, here is where the lag displays are. It could take a little bit of time. So right now, GoDaddy at least is pretty fast. Some of the other providers are pretty fast as well as far as updating the DNS records. As soon as those records are sort of public and sort of approved and put on their system, then you can go ahead and complete and just use add on this one here. We're going to see, give it just another couple seconds here, but when you click add, Highlevel is going to go out and check to make sure that the A record and CNAME record exist for this domain and are set up correctly. And if they are, then it will complete the process and then bring the domain inside of Highlevel. So let's click here and see what we get. Okay, perfectly. So that didn't take that long at all. So now we've added it, and now it's going to ask us, how do we want to link this? So here in this particular point, the domain is already added. Right now, it's just, this is sort of a shortcut saying, which one of these sites do you want to connect it to? Now notice that this connects to websites and funnels. This free $50 gift card was a funnel. So you can connect it directly here to a website or a funnel. I'm going to connect this to the complete massage and spa. So right now, once we do this, it's going to ask for what page, sort of where do you want to be the default page that people land on. And right now, the default page we have set here is just home. Once we do that, we link it. Everything is great. Now, at this particular point, if we come back to our sites, come back to complete massage and spa and go to our settings, notice that the domain has been configured here. So right now, let's just test this and see how this works. So voila, we go to a web browser, we type in complete massage and spa, and it pulls up the website and everything is great. So that is one way that you can configure a root domain. Now, what we're going to also do is a lot of times you're going to, besides having root domains, you're going to want to configure other subdomains. It could be sales. It could be, you know, funnel.completemassageandspa.com. It could be whatever, but you're going to need to configure a subdomain at some point. So how does that actually work? So let's go ahead and get that set up here as well. So we're going to need to go back into our settings. We're going to need to go back into domains. Now we're going to set up a subdomain. The domain that I spoke of just a little while ago was just app.app.completemassageandspa.com. So we're going to come here and add. We're going to do app.completemassageandspa.com. So here it gives us very similar instructions. We still have an IP address here. I will copy that address. Now we need to create an A record pointing to this. A little bit different on this one. I'll show you what we're doing here. So we're going to create the same records again. We're going to choose an A record. Now here, instead of using the at symbol, this is subdomain. So now we have to point the subdomain name here. So the subdomain that we're using is app. So that's all we type there is just app, APP. Because that's the name in front of the dot in front of the root domain. Now the value for this, we're going to type in the IP address. We're going to just click save. Updating the records here. Now we also need to create a CNAME record. So we're going to create a CNAME record here. And I need to come back over here and do a copy of this guy. So we're going to just highlight this. Copy. Now notice what it says here for the domain. You need to create a CNAME record pointing to this address for APP in domain. Okay, so that's important. So in the CNAME here, the name we're going to type in APP. That's all we're going to type in. And we're going to link it to this and just simply click save. Up. Oh, it looks like we already have another one. So let's take a look here. So let's see if we just put in the full domain name here. Awesome. Get that set up. Now, again, just giving it just, give it a 30 seconds or so just to kind of see, but it just needs to register those records in the DNS, and then when you do that, you should be able to come over here and just click add. Great. That didn't take very long at all, so that's great. So now we have to assign this to a funnel. I'm just going to put this to full website here, and we're going to take a look at that and what page on this are we going to go to. Just the home page. Link it. Give it just a second to get that finished. Now we're going to come back over here to sites. And under this, we've got the full website right here. So I'm going to open that up and just notice this is just sort of a different website template that I have. It's just a sample site. We're going to go to settings and notice that app.completemassageandspa.com is listed. So right now, if we're going to go here and type in app.complete, make sure I don't misspell anything here, massageandspa.com. We should get the other website here, so give it just a second to get loaded. Now, there may very well be delays in some of these because sometimes the way the internet works, it might be delayed. It could even be as long as a couple of hours. But this right here, it didn't take that long. We did pull up a different website here. So we've got this site. And going back, we've got the Complete Massage and Spa site. So just notice that these are different here. So we can simply get these created. We've got the Complete Massage, and then we've got a subdomain which goes to this other additional website. So inside of Highlevel, this is how you would go through and set up your domains. I know this is a very basic function here because having all of your websites hosted through GoHighlevel, I know it doesn't sound like a whole lot, but I mean, if you're looking at $10-$15 per month per site for hosting, for certain providers, I mean, depending on how many websites you have, how many funnels you want to run, I mean, that can be just a couple of $100 a month just in website hosting fees that you're going to be paying to GoDaddy or some other person just to host all of these websites and funnels. Well, you don't need to pay for that fee in Highlevel. The only thing you need to do is you need to just sit back and configure the domains, configure all the funnels and websites, and then GoHighlevel hosts all of those for you. Now, please keep this in mind. GoHighlevel is not a domain register. So you cannot buy domains. You cannot configure domains. GoHighlevel does not do that. So you will still need something like GoDaddy, Bluehost, some other kind of provider like that to buy the domain and so forth. So anyway, that's how you set them up. It's really not that bad. As you can see, it just took a little bit of time to get it set up. It is a little bit technical, but hopefully you could follow those instructions and be able to set it up for yourself. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please click subscribe if you liked it. Click on the like, click on the little bell icon to kind of give me some support on this channel. I would appreciate it, and thank you so much, and have a great day. Hey, I want to thank you again for visiting my channel and give you one more little thing here. If you are interested in Highlevel and getting some additional Highlevel training, please see the link in the description below. I do have a free course I'm offering that covers everything related to Highlevel and gives you all the information that you need to know. Thank you so much and have a great day.